super cool cars, drag cars. It's awesome. But there are some that just, they just speak to you. And those of you who know me know that I'm a Pontiac guy. And so these cars speak to me. Joey Tankersley, Joe GTO, you guys bring a great car to the racetrack, but you also bring your family to the racetrack, and they don't come to watch, they come to race. You have got a fleet of Pontiac race cars.
That's correct. Started out in 1978 with the Gold GTO. It belonged to my wife. When we were dating, we drove it on the street. And we've been married 48 years this August. She's had the car 49 years.
So you have a Pontiac-powered super comp car, and you married into this car. Like, okay, so take us back to that. Like, you meet this, you know, amazing woman, and she's got an amazing car. Like, what went through your mind?
She sent me a picture of this GTO, and I sent her a picture of my Harley Davidson chopper with my long hair. It was love at first sight for both of us.
And here you are many years later, your son and your daughter both race with you, and you drive the gold, Matt drives silver, Laurel, your daughter, runs this beautiful Pontiac Trans Am. But the thing that's interesting to me, it shouldn't be unusual, but it is, they're all Pontiac powered.
All Pontiac powered. I guess in the late 70s, somebody told me you can't make the Pontiac run, that's all it took.
They told you you couldn't do it, and so you had to do it.
I had to do it.
So she runs Super Street. We're getting a good look at the Trans Am, which the Pontiacs had a great look then and back in the 70s with the GTO. Tell me a little bit about her car first, the Super Streeter.
We bought it. It was a bracket car, and we took it to the shop. That was an excellent pro stock car back in the day.
Yes.
It was very dynamic, and we had to add weight to it and rewired the car, replumbed the car. It had a big block Chevrolet in it, so had foot struts on the front half of the car, but she loves the car, and it's a fun car to drive. I drove it once at Bristol. The car works really well.
They make such great cars. So she's running Super Street, you're in Super Com, but Matt with the silver GTO, both with vinyl roofs. You guys doing that on purpose, like the team atmosphere? Tell us a little bit about the silver one before we get to your own vehicle.
Bought the silver one in 1995. And they both have Jerry Bickle chassis under them. They're Lamb struts in the front, Mark Williams rear ends. Both of them have Brunos with three-speed Lincos, manually shifted with a Pontiac under the hood, always Pontiac.
So everybody out there who's watching this right now just said, what? Lenco transmissions.
Manually shifted, three speeds.
Now, why? Why? Like, this is the essence of what we always talk about. The drag racers, you already said, someone told you you can't do it, and so you did it. Is that in the same
realm? They say the power glides are a lot more consistent, but they're also a lot more boring for me. But they, if you like a power glide, you like a power glide. If you like a big block Chevrolet, you like a big block Chevrolet.
Exactly. No, nothing negative on those things, but we need variety.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
We're getting a great look at Matt's car right now. Thing is fantastic. The Pontiac logo right on the front. And he runs Super Gas. You like to run Super Gas or Super Comp most of the time. So you guys are split up in the categories. Why do you choose that?
I just don't like to travel this far and run the same class as one of the other cars. And it's not like we're in it for the money. We're just out having family fun, enjoying ourselves. And I like to be in a different class so we don't pair up against each other early on. It's a little more competitive. Super Comp is really competitive with the dragsters, but like I say, we're just having fun.
Well, I love what I'm seeing. Now let's focus in on your car, Joe. You mentioned your wife. It was hers. She obviously supports this greatly. Otherwise, you would not be here. Pontiac engine, Lenco-style transmission, but I want to see under the hood. Can we see? Can we see under the hood?
Uh-huh.
Yes. We are going to lift the hood on this and reveal what a Pontiac engine looks like these days. Now, this is no classic Pontiac iron block made by a factory. This is modern era Pontiac technology.
Set the scoop off. Matt, set the scoop off right quick. It's four.
There you go. Ram air.
Ram air five.
Five.
It's kind of something we're experimenting with.
Now that's all new. That's all relatively new.
Yeah.
I remember as a guy who has a Pontiac bracket car, finding parts was a challenge back in the day. You've got Ram Air 5, all aluminum. That thing is spectacular. And Wilson Manifolds did your intake.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I know Keith. Keith is right by me. He's my neighbor.
Jeff Wilkerson has built the engine. Self Racing in Oklahoma, they're building Mata intake for his Ram Air 5. We're putting him together, Ram Air 5. Hope to have it out by the end of the season.
See, for me, this is amazing because I've never seen one of these, frankly. And just to see the exhaust port layout, the Ram Air 5, and not to go too deeply into it because not everybody's a Pontiac person, but that was what was next.
Yeah.
And then they decided, yeah, all right, this performance stuff maybe is, you know, fuel crisis, all that. But now the racers have got back, and what a straight run from carburetor to intake right out the exhaust. They finally got it right.
Reversed the valve, intake valve and exhaust position to keep the heat away from the center of the head gasket. That's the dry deck block and the heads. So we use an inline stop with the 2.4s, air cylinder, with have dual regulators, two separate bottles, just not necessarily that I have to, but I was trying to eliminate some problems.
Now, if this thing ran wide open without a throttle stop, we know why you're running .90, because it's fun, because it keeps it affordable, but if you went wide open throttle with this thing, what would it run?
Just guessing 780s, 790s with the maybe 170.
Very nice.
Good mile an hour. It went to 165 at 890.
All right, so all the Pontiac people are probably going crazy. I think everybody's going crazy right now, loving what we're seeing, because it's like jewelry under the hood. But I would love to see you inside the car. Can you do that for us?
Okay.
All right, Joe's going to get in the car. Pontiac GTOs, we got Trans Ams. This is what it's all about. And Joe, what is that, chromed? Whoa. You got a lot of extra bells and whistles going on in there, Joe.
Yeah, we put the slide-away steering wheel. CSI actually made that in the early 90s, and we put them in both of these cars. You don't see very many. I don't know if I've ever seen another one at the track. It's a lot easier to get in and out, and you don't have to worry about putting the steering wheel back at the same place.
Hop in there. I like that. I like it. And, you know, people say it's a drag race and it's not a car show, which I vehemently disagree with that. I think it's both. And that's why we're doing this show. So you got a lot of chrome. The wheel is awesome. You are now in your office. Take us through, your procedure on the starting line as you're getting ready for a run. Like, walk everybody through.
With the Bruno.
And you can switch the microphone so you got your right arm if you need me.
Okay. With the Bruno and three-speed Lenco, this is first gear. When this lever is back, that's neutral. Then up here is reverse. You put this back here to take off. It's 7,000. Sometimes I play with different RPMs. It likes high RPMs, but I'm shifting on the 7,000. I pull second gear. Then when it comes off, after it comes off the stop, I'm on the stop for 2.54 seconds. There you get the. Then I pull the third gear. We can run with the three-speed Lenco, we can run a lower first gear than we can a Power Glide with the heavy cars. It's almost 2,800 pound with me in it. So, but we have it reacting. I've got 35 delay and just had a whole one light in the box. But it's not complicated. Normally I don't have two CO2 bottles, but I'm just playing with that on the throttle stop.
Got it. Now, when are you looking for your competition? With all the shifting that's going on, can you look prior to going into high gear, or you wait till you're in high gear?
They're about 20 to 30 mile an hour more than me, so I'm normally close to the mile an hour light before I pay much attention to them.
Got it. All right, this has been awesome for me as someone who has a Pontiac, but I would love to hear this thing fire up if you can do that for the people at home.
Okay.
We're going to light it up, baby. Joe Tankersley, Ram Air 5, Pontiac. The car is incredible, and he's bringing his whole family. He's got his son Matt, his daughter Laurel. His wife is out here. She brought the car to the family. Just a great combination. And you have another daughter who wants in as well. What are you going to do, Joe?
Not sure. I think I need some extra strength Geritol.
Joe, thank you so much for showing us your car and sharing it all with us.
Okay, appreciate it.
And that's why you come out into the pits at the NHRA.
Subscribe now.